The Sahaba who rejected Umar's prohibition of mut'a marriage and continued to allow and practice it. A big group of Sahaba led by Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib maintained their opinion on the legality of temporary marriage. They deemed Umar's prohibition unlawful. However, their words were filtered out from the prominent Sahih books in order to suppress the truth about this matter. We will go through the opinions of some important Sahaba and Tabi'een in regards to this matter. Ibn Hazm al-Andalusi says in his book Al-Muhalla Al-Muniriyya Volume 9 pages 519 and 520. After the death of the messenger, a group of the Salaf maintained that mut'a marriage was still lawful, and some of them were companions such as Asma, the daughter of Abu Bakr, Jabir ibn Abdullah, Ibn Mas'ud, Ibn Abbas, Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, Amr ibn Huraith, Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, and Salama and Ma'bad, the sons of Umayyah ibn Khalaf. Then Ibn Hazm says, from the Tabi'een are Tawus and Ata and Sa'id ibn Jubayr and the rest of the scholars of the blessed city of Mecca. Ibn Qudama says in his book Al-Mughni Dar Alam Al-Kutub Volume 10 page 46, it was said that Ibn Abbas saw it permissible, and most of the companions of Tawus and Ata are on this opinion, as well as Ibn Juraij, Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, Jabir and the Shia. Al-Qurtubi says in his Tafsir Al-Jami' Volume 5 Dar al-Kutub al-Misriya page 133, Abu Bakr al-Tartusi has said that no one allowed mut'a marriage except Imran bin Hussein, Ibn Abbas and some of the Sahaba and a group of Ahlul Bayt. Then Al-Qurtubi says, Abu Umar has said, all of the companions of Ibn Abbas from Mecca and Yemen see mut'a marriage as halal and lawful and have the same opinion as Ibn Abbas. This same statement by Al-Qurtubi was also repeated by Al-Tha'labi in his Tafsir Al-Kashf wal-Bayan in Part 3, Dar Ihya al-Turath al-Arabi, pages 286 and 287. Ibn Abdul Barr narrates in his book Al-Tamheed, Majmu'at al-Tuhaf al-Nafa'is al-Duwaliyya, Volume 10, page 63. From Abdul Razzaq, from Ibn Juraij, from Ata, that he said, I heard from Ibn Abbas that he sees mut'a marriage as halal until now, and he informed me that he reads verse 424 as, for the pleasure you obtained from them to a specified period of time, give them their rewards, and also in the harf of Ubay, to a specified period of time. Abu Umar said, others who also read this verse as to a specified period of time are Ali, the son of Hussein, his son Abu Ja'far Muhammad bin Ali, and his son Ja'far bin Muhammad, and Sa'id bin Jubayr. They all read it this way. Note that the narrator here, which is Ata bin Abi Rabah, was born during the time of Uthman's leadership. So the time that he heard this from Ibn Abbas must have been long time after the death of the Prophet and Umar. Therefore, this shows that Ibn Abbas insisted on rejecting Umar's verdict and deemed it unlawful. Also, if you notice the other names mentioned in this narration, you will realize that they are actually the names of three of the 12 Shia Imams, namely Ali, the son of Hussein, Zainul Abidin, and his son Muhammad bin Ali al-Baqir, and his son Ja'far bin Muhammad al-Sadiq. They all read the verse 424 according to the reading of Ibn Abbas and Ubay ibn Ka'b to insist on the lawfulness of mut'a marriage and the unlawfulness of Umar's prohibition. The first section of this narration regarding Ibn Abbas is also found in Musannaf Abdul Razzaq al-San'ani Al-Maktab al-Islami, Part 7, page 498, Hadith 14022. ابن عاشور also mentions in his تفسير التحرير والتنوير الدار التونسية volume 5 page 10 It is proven that people did mut'a marriages and that Ali ibn Abi Talib and Imran bin Hussein and Ibn Abbas and a group of the Sahaba and Tabi'een regarded mut'a marriage permissible and this is the opinion of the Imamis. These same names that were mentioned by Ibn Ashur were also mentioned by Fakhruddin al-Razi in his Tafsir al-Kabir, Dar al-Fikr, volume 10, pages 50 and 51 and 53 and 54. Ibn Rushd says in his book Sharh Bidayat al-Mujtahid Dar al-Salam, volume 3, page 1370. Ibn Abbas was famous for allowing mut'a marriage and his companions from Mecca and Yemen followed him in this opinion. And it was narrated that Ibn Abbas used verse 424 to argue his point and according to his harf to a specified period of time. Imam Ali was widely reported to have said لولا نهى عمر عن المتعة ما زنى إلا شقي Translation If Umar did not forbid mut'a then no one would commit fornication except the very evil This famous saying of Imam Ali was not only narrated on a wide scale but was also constantly repeated by Imam Ali's followers like Ibn Abbas on many different occasions It was basically used by them as a slogan to argue against those who prohibited the lawful of Allah. This saying, with some slight variation in the wording, was reported to have been heard from Imam Ali in many different sources. For example, Al-Tabari narrated in his Tafsir, Part 6, Dar Hajr, page 588, from Muhammad bin Al-Muthanna, from Muhammad bin Ja'far, from Shu'bah that he said, I asked Al-Hakam about this verse 424 for the pleasure you obtain from them pay them their rewards is it an abrogated verse Al-Hakam said no Ali has said if Umar did not forbid mut'a then no one would have committed zina except the very evil this same hadith by Al-Hakam was also narrated by Al-Tha'labi in his tafsir Al-Kashf wal-Bayan Part 3, Dar Ihya al-Turath al-Arabi, page 286. Abdul Razzaq al-San'ani has also narrated similar to this meaning via Ibn Juraj. Musannaf Abdul Razzaq, Al-Maktab al-Islami, part 7, page 500. It was also quoted by Al-Suyuti in his Tafsir Al-Durr al-Manthur, Markaz Hajr, Part 4, page 331. And Fakhruddin al-Razi in his Tafsir al-Kabir, Dar al-Fikr, Part 10, page 51. This saying was constantly repeated by Imam Ali's supporters such as Ibn Abbas. Therefore, it was reported to have been heard from Ibn Abbas on many different occasions with slight variation in the wording, as you will see in the following narrations. Al-Tahawi narrated in Sharh Ma'ani al-Athar, Part 3, Alam al-Kutub, page 26. From Ibn Juraj, from Ata, that he said, Ibn Abbas said, Mut'a was a mercy from Allah that he bestowed on this nation. And if Umar did not prohibit mut'a, then no one would commit zina except the very evil. Similar to this meaning was also narrated by Ibn Rushd in Sharh Bidayat al-Mujtahid, volume 3, Dar al-Salam, page 1370. Abdul Razzaq has also narrated a similar thing in his Musannaf. Part 7, pages 496 and 497. And Ibn Abdul Barr in his Tamheed, Part 10, page 64. This saying was also quoted by Al-Qurtubi in his Tafsir Al-Jami', Volume 5, page 130. And finally, but with a slightly different meaning, by Ibn Ashur, in his Tafsir Al-Tahrir Wal-Tanwir, Volume 5, page 10. To conclude this section, we will mention an interesting incident which shows the way that many Sahaba and Tabi'een dealt with Umar's verdict. Narrated by Yahya bin Aktham in Muhadarat al-Udaba for al-Isfahani, Dar Maktabat al-Hayat, Volume 2, Part 3, page 214. Yahya bin Aktham asked the Sheikh of Basra, "Who did you follow in the permissibility of Mut'a?" He said, "I followed Umar ibn al-Khattab." Yahya said, "How can that be when Umar was the strongest opposer of it?" He replied, "The authentic report is that Umar went up on the pulpit and said, 'Allah and His Messenger have allowed you two mut'as, and I am forbidding them on you and punishing upon them. So we have accepted his testimony, but we have rejected his prohibition.'"